Hi friends, so in this video we are going to discuss about main function in Java program. So the funny question is, main function is required in Java program or not? Yes, the main function is required in Java program, because while you are giving the execution command, the JVM, Java Virtual Machine, look for a member function to execute. So that member function is a main function. So Java Virtual Machine will find the member function of that is a main function. Then it will start the execution. So before going into this main function execution, we'll discuss some of the executions. So if the main function have four keywords are there. One is a public, and second one is a static, and the third one is a void, and the fourth one is a member function name, that is main. So if I remove that the public, that is the access specifier, if I remove that one, so you can see it in the screen, automatically you will get an error while you're executing it. Then if I add public, and if I remove the static, that is a without object, you can execute a particular member function. So if I want to execute a main function without object, I need this static. But if I remove the static keyword, so you can see it in the screen, that is an error. Error will come. The same time, if I remove, that is a void. Okay, so this member function, main member function, no need to return anything. So that's why we are mentioning this return type as void. So if I remove this particular word keyword, automatically you will get the error. You can see it in the screen, you will get the error. And the fourth one is inside the member function. There are one argument is there, that is that which kind of argument you are passing through this member function. Okay, so if I'm removing that string, then array an argument. If I remove this one, again you will get an error. Okay, so there is a signature inside the Java definition. Okay, if you want to declare a member function, that is a main member function, then this is the signature. Okay, public, static, void, main, and inside the function you need to mention that argument, that is a string data type that need to be mentioned. So now we'll discuss one by one how the program, that is the program, will be executed. Then inside the program, how you can define the member function. Already in the starting of the video, we discussed about what are the major components inside the class, right? So if you want to write a Java program, you need to remember three things. So one is a package. So there you need to mention just like a header file, right? Import java dot util dot star and a semicolon, right? This is how you need to define the that is a package declaration. So after that, you need to declare the class. So you can see it in the screen. There are two ways you can declare the class. So your class must be public. So the access specifier must be public. So public, then the keyword class, then the class name. So this is how you can mention, or you can directly mention the keyword class and class name. So you can see it in the screen. These are the two ways you can declare a class. So inside the class, you can declare many things. So different types of variables you can declare it. That is a static variable, local variable, then instance variable. That is a data variable. So all these things you can mention inside. And one more thing, you can declare the member function. So there are different types of member function. One is a constructor, you can define it. And one more thing is member function, user defined member function, you can declare it. And one more thing is you must declare this main function. So main function is required, already we discussed. So main function is required to execute the whole program. So JVM, while you're giving the execution command, this JVM looks for a main function inside the program. So that's why you need this main function inside the Java program. So now you can understand why this main function is required in Java program, right? So now you can see that what are the four components in a main function, right? One is the three are the keywords. One is the public, and second one is the static, and third one is a void. Then you can mention the name, that is a main. So after that, what are the arguments you can send it inside? Okay, send through this particular main function. So one by one, we can discuss in this video. First one is an access specifier. So the main function need to be accessed outside of the class. Example, if the JVM is looking for the main function, because the JVM is accessing the member function from the outside of the class. Okay, so you must declare this member function, that is a main function, need to be public. So this is the access specifier. Public is the access specifier. And second one is a static. So now, so you want to execute any member function inside the class, it requires the object, or you must mention the word static. So static means without object declaration, object creation, you can execute that particular member function in through main function. So now this main function also need to be accessed without object creation. So JVM will look for a main function and it need to be static. Without object creation, you can execute the main member function. Okay. So then the third one is a void. So main function, no need to return any data. So the return data, return type must be void. So this is the third one. And the fourth one is, you need to remember how many arguments can be passed inside a particular member function. So here there is a condition, in the main member function you can pass only one argument, that is a string argument. Okay, so that string can be an array. Okay, so array of arguments can be passed, but only one argument you can pass through this particular member function. So this is the structure of the main function. Okay, so you need to remember these four things. One is the public, that is access specifier. And second one is the static. So without object creation, you can execute this. You can call this main function and execute. That is the second one. And the third one is void. So main function will not return anything. So that's why we are mentioning that return type is void. And the fourth one is how many arguments you can pass through this member function. Okay, so this, so there is only one member, only one argument you can pass through this particular member function, that is string. So that string argument can be an array. So array of arguments can be passed. In the last, you can see that array of arguments, why it is required. So command line argument. Okay, so while you are executing the program, so example, you can see it in the screen. Some of the steps I have mentioned, right? So why I need to mention that string argument inside the main member function. After that, I have used one for loop to find out what is the number of arguments, that is arguments length. Okay, so then I'm printing that number of arguments. Okay, so there I'm just receiving. So while I'm giving the command line arguments, example, if I'm compiling, after compiling, while I'm executing the Java program, that is Java, then class name, then number of arguments. If I'm giving that automatically, that those arguments will come to the main function arguments, then it will come inside the main function, then it can be printed. Okay, so you can see this particular structure and how it's executing. Okay, so you need to remember two things. One, how structure is. Okay, simple Java program structure. That is a package, then the class name, class and the class name and the main function. Okay, so inside the main function, what are the things you need to remember? Four things you need to remember in the main function. And the three are the keywords, right? And the first one is the public, and second one is the static, and the third one is the void, that is a return type. And the fourth one you need to remember, how many arguments you can pass through this particular main function. So only one argument, that is string. Okay, so this is how you can understand why this main function is required. In main function, why I'm mentioning all these keywords, right? Public, static, void, why I'm mentioning, and why the string is required. All these things you can understand in this video.